Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Sylvie, High Level Queen, and today we are going to talk about what not to do when you're setting up your calendars inside High Level, and also the difference between one-way and two-way sync. So let's get started. So for those of you guys who don't know, we actually have a free Facebook group called Marketing Agency Automation Secrets, where we give away hundreds of dollars in free trainings every single week to our members. So click the link below to go check that out. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is set up your integrations if you have not already done that. So you're going to go to settings at the bottom left corner, and then you're going to click on integrations. And then what you want to do is you want to connect your Google account, okay? Make sure that you're using the account that you want to sync your calendar with, all right? Then step two is you want to create your calendar. So you're going to click on calendars and you're going to click on add calendar. Okay, so step three, you're going to create the settings in your calendar. Now there's a bunch of different options here that I actually cover in another YouTube video, but basically, what you need to know is you're going to name your calendar, then auto confirm just means that it's automatically going to confirm the appointment and add it to your Google Calendar as well. Okay. Also, you can put your Zoom link or your address or whatever you want to put as far as location here, and it'll be added in location for all the calendar invites. And also, you can set your minimum scheduling notice, your range. So this is like the total range if you only want them to be able to schedule 5 days out, for example. And you can put your Facebook pixel in here. You can do all kinds of cool things. But the thing that I really wanted to stress that I see a lot of people making this mistake in the calendar settings. Step four, you want to set the correct sync options. Now, I see this mistake made a lot because people don't understand what the sync options mean. So, after you select your calendar provider here, which is the calendar that you synced to Google, sync options. Two-way means that basically all the events from the Google Calendar are going to be synced. All the events will talk to each other back and forth. So it's a two-way kind of communication, which means that if you set an event in your Google Calendar, that it will be added into High Level. The recipients will be added as a lead into High Level, and it's going to import everything from Google. Okay. If you're using Google for your personal calendar invitations, like let's say that you have a dentist appointment, for example, and you put your dentist appointment in Google and you have two-way sync turned on, it is going to pull in your dentist email address and all the information as a lead in High Level. You're going to be sending your dentist all of the appointment reminders that you have set for that trigger. So that is right, guys. You heard me right. Anyone who you enter into your personal calendar in Google is going to start getting your High Level appointment reminders. If you do not want this to happen, which 99% chance you probably don't, you want to use one way. Okay. So one way just basically means that the events from your Google Calendar are going to be gray, and it is not going to add the people that are in your Google Calendar into High Level. Okay. So it's only going to send appointment reminders to the people who you schedule an appointment with inside of High Level, which, like I said, 99% of the time is what you want, okay? So that's the number one mistake that I see with High Level calendars is people using two-way, and then they ask, why am I getting all these weird leads? Why is my dentist in High Level? What's going on? We had a client who used his personal calendar for all of his flights, and he was asking, like, why are the airlines added to my High Level as a lead? And that's why. Okay, so that's probably the issue here. You just need to switch it to one way. Okay, and then disable trigger just means that it's not going to fire at all. It's not going to fire appointment reminders at all. Okay, we don't see that too often either. So hopefully this helps you guys, and make sure that you like and subscribe so you don't miss any future updates from me, and I'll see you guys next time.